What is up, people? Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you about five ways in which you can build up your game industry network. As I always say, the only way or the best way to get into the game industry is through your network, because 70% of the jobs are not even put out on websites or LinkedIn. They are just hired through the network in the game industry. So I'm going to be telling you about how you can build up your network in the game industry like this. So let's go. I'm Rahul Sehgal. I'm the founder of Game2Maker, India's number one online game development platform. The link to the courses is in the description, so do check it out. Also, make sure that you follow me on Instagram for all the latest tips, tricks, and hacks on game development. Now, let's talk about game industry network. Now, your game industry network is gonna get you a job, and you know how. The way it normally works in the game industry is that if I'm a game designer, if I'm a game design lead and I want to hire someone for my team, what I do is I actually call my people, my peers, and I say, hey guys, there's a role open in my team. Do you want to apply? And I actually get the resumes straight from my friends, my colleagues, my co-workers. I ask my team, guys, do you know someone else who can do this game art role? And they send recommendations, they send resumes of their friends, their peers, etc. And then these resumes are actually handed over to HR directly. And then I say, hey, listen, this is a recommendation I have. And here's a pro tip. In most game companies, by the way, guys, if you recommend someone and they get hired, you get something called a hiring bonus, which means you get like 30% of 1 month's pay after they complete 3 months. That's also a really good incentive to actually recommend people in the game industry. All right, but how do you build your network? Because a lot of you say, you know, sure, like I would love to have a game industry network, but I don't know anyone from the game industry. How do I get started? How do I build my network? And I'm going to tell you, number one way of starting with your game industry network is going to game development conferences. For example, the India Game Developers Conference, which happens in November every year. This is a great place. And if you want to join the game industry, if you want to build up a network, you have to go to the game industry event. You have to go to IGDC, guys. It's really, really important. You have thousands of people coming from all over the world. And now I'm going to tell you how in a game development conference, you can actually build up your network. A, you have to attend the talks. The talks are given by speakers from India, from all over the world. They speak on specific topics. So example, you want to be a game designer, go and watch the game design talks. Firstly, you'll gain a lot of insights. You get lots of information. You learn so much in these talks by speaker that's not even funny. And after the talk is over, I would recommend that you can actually go up and say hello to the speaker. Now, don't just go to the speaker and be like, hey, I'm so-and-so, nice to meet you. Because trust me, I've been a speaker. I know that at the end of your talk, there are dozens of people who want to talk to you, tell you about their games, etc., etc. So one really good way to stand out is to actually go and mention something that the speaker said. Say, you know, for example, I loved your take on, you know, how the free-to-play game economy is going to be blah, 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 whatever. Just talk about something that they said, praise them, and then after you massage their ego a little bit, they're going to definitely remember you a little bit better. And after you've done that, you can give them your card or take their card and then find them on LinkedIn. Find them on LinkedIn within a few days and then send them a message, send them a connection request and say, hey, I'm so-and-so, we met at the end of the conference. And make sure you have a decent LinkedIn picture which actually looks like you. And then they might remember you. And then that is the start of your network. Secondly, you just meet people at game conferences just walking around, right? There are mixers. There is the expo floor. You have to be a little bit of an extrovert. Even if you're an introvert, that's fine. You have to make the effort to go and meet people and talk to them. Look, you're not going to be building your network by just sitting in your room, okay? For that, you actually have to meet people. Sorry to let you know about that. So go introduce yourselves to people, collect their cards, And most importantly, remember, at game conferences, it's very, very important to follow up. It's not enough to just say, hi, I'm so-and-so. If you get someone's card or if you get someone's phone number, make sure that once the conference is finished, you've gone home, actually email them, give them a call and say, hey guys, hey, hi, so-and-so, we met, it was nice to meet you, it was lovely to be in touch. And that is how you actually build your network from conferences. Next up, let's talk about institutes, colleges. Now, for me personally, my game industry network started at Vancouver Film School. The cool thing about schools and colleges and institute is that there are a lot of students who are going to be in that batch with you. And all of you, hopefully, are going to be in the game industry someday. And those are going to be your friends. Those are going to be your colleagues. Those are going to be your batchmates. And that is an amazing way to start a game industry network. Also, at an institute, hopefully, you have, you know, like at Gamer to Maker, we actually have instructors from the game industry teaching you. So if you, your instructors are also going to be your game industry network, they are senior people in the game industry. If you do well, if you're a good student, they will actually notice you and you're like, hey, I remember you from my class, you were really good. And they're probably going to recommend you, and they are going to be a really, really strong part of your game industry network, right? So make sure that if you are doing a course from a college or an institute or something, you're going somewhere, you actually have this kind of network, you actually have this kind of community, okay? Next up, let's talk about Discord servers. Now, you should actually go and join different Discord servers for game development, such as gamedev.in, or you can even join the Gamer to Maker server. All the links are in the description of this video. And that is where you actually get to know people. Now, Discord servers are not that great because you mostly meet people at the same level, the senior people. You don't even know them because everyone has a Discord name, right? No one actually uses their own real name on Discord. So you can kind of like talk to people, discuss things with them, and very, very slowly get to know them at a personal level. And that Discord servers, but my recommendation is don't go on Discord server to just shitpost and post memes and be on the chat. Actually try and talk to people, use Discord, especially the game dev Discord, as a professional medium. Don't get too personal on it because remember, your reputation depends on your behavior with other people. Also try and have like not a totally crazy username on Discord. Try and kind of use your name a little bit. Try and not have a too crazy profile picture. Try not to be too wild on Discord because remember, you want to be a professional, right? And not just a gamer who's looking to be cool on the internet, right? When you're being a professional, that stuff actually changes. Another great place to build your network is game dev meetup. So if you live in a city which is reasonably big, such as Hyderabad or Bangalore, I'm sure there will be game devs meetup happening. So for example, IGDC has a dev day. India Game Development Conference actually has a dev day, which is across in several cities. So that's a really great place for you to go. And over there, again, you have speakers talking about stuff. You have lots of people from the game industry coming. And that's where you can actually meet people, talk to them, introduce yourself, tell them about what you're doing, and maintain that contact. Remember, once again, people will forget you if you don't follow up. So if you get someone's number, if you get someone's card, try and follow up and just say, hello, how are you guys doing? I'm so and so. Don't bother them too much, otherwise they'll block you. But that's a great way to get started. Say, hey, we talked at so and so event. Well, great talking to you. Thank you so much, etc. Also, LinkedIn is a really, really good way to do these follow-ups. Lastly, a good way to actually build your network is social media, such as Facebook and Instagram. And trust me, I get so many messages on Instagram that it's not even funny. But I've actually got some really good messages from people, and I've actually responded to them and started a really good conversation. They've become part of my network. Okay, never, ever, ever just send a DM to someone saying hi. Okay, it's very irritating. And if you want to send a message to someone, say hi. For example, I get a message saying, hi, Rahul, hope you're doing well. I'm so-and-so. Just give a really brief description about your name, where you live, what you do. And in very, very briefly, talk about what you want from that person. Can you perhaps give me some advice? Or perhaps can you guide me to someone? Or I just wanted to stay connected with you. Don't just say hi and leave it at that. Actually write a short, brief message and make sure that your English is good. You know, you can even use AI to make sure that your message is brief It's to the point. Don't make grammatical mistakes, right? So you can reach out to people, get to know them on social media through their DMs or on Instagram, Facebook, etc. But make sure that you follow these. Don't bother people. Don't like harass people asking for information. Be polite, be to the point, and you can really build up a good game industry network using all of these methods that I told you, okay? Lastly, if you want a very strong game development network within 1 year, do look at Game to Maker, because we have India's only authorized game development courses, and everyone who joins G2M builds a really, really strong network in the game industry within a year. So do check it out. And let me know what you think about this video. Give me any feedback and let me know what other videos you want me to make content on. So let's go.